If you ever wanted to know how to crop and resize images in Adobe Premiere Rush so they'll fit full screen parts of your screen, well, you are in luck, because I'm going to show you how to do that coming right up. What's going on, everybody? Claudio here, and welcome to my channel. I am Claudius, where I share tips and tools on how you can share your story. As I mentioned at the start, I'm going to show you in Adobe Premiere Rush how you can crop and resize images and place them anywhere on your screen as pop-ups or full screen. So without any further ado, let's go ahead and jump into Premiere Rush. I've already launched Adobe Premiere Rush and added a video clip here of one of my previous videos. What I'm going to do is overlay some images and show you how to crop them, as I was talking about earlier. So to do that, let's go ahead and bring in some images. Let's look for some media. I have some items on my desktop here. Created a folder. Let's go to desktop here. We have an images folder right here. Let me start off with, let me do this one right here. In fact, actually, I'm going to go ahead and add several here and kind of give you some tips on how to crop these depending on what you're trying to do. It's going to add all of these at the same time at the end. So what I'm going to do here is grab like one, or actually let's grab all of them. Let's go ahead and make our screen a little easier to see here. And let's place them up here towards the beginning. There we go. And let me show you more of the screen here, or I should say the timeline. And let's just slide these over a bit so that I will focus on one image at a time. So here, okay, let's do this. Right about there. Let me slide this guy over here. A little bit of play around here. Forgive the clicks there that you are hearing. And right here. So with this image here, as you can see, it's centered. It's not a full size like 1080. What I'm going to do is crop this and size it up and put it like on to either my right or left here. Over on the right hand side, there is a transformation tool or transform tool. And what I'm going to do here, basically it gives me the options of where I want to place this image. So you have horizontal axes and you have the vertical. You can also rotate image. Really, really neat different ways that you can be creative here. And then you can change the opacity and stuff like that. First off, what I'm going to do is come down here where it says scale, and then there's an advanced option here. With the advanced option, this is really neat. What you can do here is you can crop the images from either side, either four sides. So check this out. So if I say right side, look what it does to the image. So I'm cropping it. Let's say I want to kind of have it squared, even though I didn't take the picture as a square portrait, it's actually landscape. But if I go left to right, I can kind of play with it and get it close enough to look like it's a square. And then if I want to check this out right here, I can do some edging, sort of feathering on the edges, but I'm not going to do that. I'm going to leave it the way it is. And now what I'm left to do is either move it over here to my right as I'm looking here, but actually on the left here. And let's go ahead and resize that, bring it a little bit smaller, and now adjust it vertically. So boom, there it is. So if I was doing a little tutorial video or something and I wanted to drop in a picture and put it either right or left and crop it, this is a way to do it. So you're going to use the transform tool. So let's go ahead and let's move that out of the way and let's bring another one here. This time I have this image, and let's say I want to increase or actually fill the whole screen with this image. Now here's a little bit of a tricky part is I took the picture and it's in kind of a portrait mode. So I'm going to lose some parts of this image either at the top or bottom. So you just kind of have to decide what you want to do. So if I keep increasing the size, you can see as I was talking about how it actually doesn't really fit the whole screen. So I don't have enough to fill this whole screen. So this is one of those things you kind of have to be prepared to kind of to play with. So let's see here. Maybe I can tweak it a little bit more. No, so this image probably is not going to work out. Oh, there we go. Let's grab those lines so I can increase it further by doing that. And there it is. So I've lost some area of the picture. I could either choose to do that we'll bring it down here. So this is one of those things where you kind of have to decide what you want to do with the image. So increase it with maintaining the proportions, and then grab that little handle there and bring it out. So that's the other way, increase the size. So now the next thing, let's go ahead and bring another image here. And now it's kind of the same thing. And this time I'm going to actually place this image onto the other side here. So let's go to this side here and let's bring that image down. Same thing, this time instead of cropping right and left, I'm going to crop from the top and kind of have it right about there. Fix the positioning there, adjust it. So in my videos, when I work and add images like this, kind of like a while back, I did some different types of examples and I throw them up there. That's kind of what I do, and just crop them. And again, if you didn't take the picture in a square format, this is an easy way to manipulate them and make them look like you did take the pictures in that format. So using the cropping tool in the advanced, really neat. All right, one more here and then we'll kind of wrap this up. Let's go ahead and let's move this image here. Now this one, if I increase the size, I can fill the whole screen. But what I want to do with this one is I'm going to decrease, actually make it a little bit smaller, and let's go ahead and do some cropping. I'm just going to really like mess with this picture. And then let's make it larger. And adjust where I want to place it. This time, let's just put it here at the bottom. Kind of one of the tricks that I do here is whenever I do these picture-in-picture kind of things, one of the neat things, let's go ahead and crop a little bit more on the bottom there. And then you can really kind of get all the way down here, place it like on the left-hand corner to make it kind of look like one of those picture-in-picture examples. So if you wanted to place different pictures on the corners, this is kind of a quick, easy way to do that. If I wanted to do that, let's go ahead and layer this on top. Now I got that other picture there. So let me do the same thing. Let's go ahead and place that picture all the way to the top. And then let's go ahead and crop that one more. Make it just a little bit bigger so it matches down there what's at the bottom, and put it to the top. So you can easily do this and add pictures like all on four corners. So put four different examples. So really easy way to crop images, even though I didn't take those pictures in that format. Bring them in here, click on them, and then go to the transform tool and do some cropping, resizing. Really, really easy way to do that. Hopefully you learned something new, something helpful the next time you are editing in Adobe Premiere Rush. Let me know what you thought about this video. If you have any questions, add it in the comment section below. Don't forget to hit that like button. Subscribe to this channel if you haven't done so, and then click that little bell to be notified for future videos. Keep creating, and thank you for watching this video. Be good to one another. Peace. I'm out.